in sight in the 80s and 90s. Not quite as frequent since, but it's back. Playoff football in the Bay Area here at Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. Straight ahead, it's Wild Card Weekend, and we've got a great one in store between the New Orleans Saints and the San Francisco 49ers. Win or go home is the mantra, and off we go. We're underway in this NFC Wild Card game. Here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. Right to the air. Here's Murray. Treads him with a stiff arm. And he is out of bounds right around the 34. An early statement on the game's first play. 18 yards and a first down. Just the first quarter of a tackling going to be so important going forward. They've got to limit plays like that.
And that's something when you see it happen early in the game and they don't get him on the ground, you can always tell that they were concerned about it going in. Because I can just tell you, from my days, I remember being in college and worrying all offseason about our season open opponent, and they had a receiver that could shake and bake with the best double. I tackled him on the first pass of the game, and the relief was incredible. Ended up having a pretty decent ball game. But if I had missed him, it would have been a long night.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Throwing out right here, caught by Olave. And down he goes at the 45 after a pickup of 9.
Well, Charles, what a rookie season he had catching the football, over 1,000 yards on the year, and he comes through there with a nice grab.
And we've seen wide receivers in recent years come in and have big years right away. And you think about Justin Jefferson in 2020, 1,400 yards and huge impact on his team and on the league. This guy, he's following his footsteps as an impact guy here in year one.
2 yards the loss, and now they go from second and 2 to a tough 3rd and 4.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
He'll find its tight end. It's Adam Trautman. His first catch of this wild card game, and it's good for a first down.
Well, on third down, he wanted to go to one of his most dependable targets, and that's who he found, his tight end there, to pick up the first, Charles.
And you used the proper word there, dependable, and sometimes spectacular, because tight ends nowadays, they can do it all. But they're the guys you trust, especially across the middle of the field where there's traffic. He delivers, and they pick up nice yardage.
Now Murray off play action. Open man downfield is Johnson. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. That one goes for 24 yards. He was out there waving his arms. And when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
Play fake. Murray. And he's got him. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Adam Trautman, an 11-yard touchdown. And the Saints will strike first here in this wild card matchup. Lutz good on the extra point. And it's now a 7-0 game. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. Taken from about the 12. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line.
offense in the 49ers now. First and 10 at their own 20-yard line. Off of play action, here's Lance. And he fires one incomplete.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
They'll need five on this play to move the sticks. From the gun on third down, Lance. Man open, that's Deebo Samuel. And he's brought down short by a yard. It's a third down gain of four. On fourth down, they'll try and run for it. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. A curious decision to go for it, but it pays off for the first down.
Good running right there. And this is a man who's a 1,000-yard rusher in the regular season, so you know he's going to get his chances. And he picks up nice yardage on that one.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
I was a Morgan trying to get him the football out of the backfield. They love what he can do in open space, and they believe that he creates mismatches they can exploit.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Play action, now it's Lance. He's got his tight end, it's Chris Manhurts. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
That was an okay hook up there with his tight end, but unfortunately, they didn't get the kind of yards they had hoped for. That's going to bring up third down.
Seventh play of the drive upcoming here on third and six. Going for it, here's Davis Price. And no room that time, getting it to about the 46. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a fourth down.
Well, this was just simply excellent defense. On this third down, they had to be alert for the possibility of a pass, but that didn't stop them at all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football, and they just swarmed and stopped them for almost no gain.
Wisnowski on to punt as he sends this one away. And this will be out of bounds. Now it's a question of where they'll mark it, and they'll say it crosses at the 11-yard line. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And they'll be looking to make this a two-score advantage. Had the touchdown on their first drive, Charles. Hey, they can get up two scores here on the road. That's a heck of a start.
And not only have they thought about it, I wonder if they visualized it. I remember playing, and they used to turn the lights out in our meeting room and run through a situation like this and say, just think about what it would be like to be up on the road and take the crowd out of it. Maybe they did some of that.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Ooh. 13 yards remaining on second down. They'll keep it on the ground. Harris again. And he's only able to work this from the 8 to the 10 for a pickup of 2. Throwing now is Murray. Oh, he rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Jordan Poyer. So this defense coming up with a takeaway, and maybe that's something that can bring a little life to that sideline.
Well, I don't want to say that they've been sleepwalking through this first half, because that's simply not true, but you're right. We haven't seen a lot of fire from these guys, really, on either side of the ball. So maybe that's the catalyst that they needed to get them back into this game.
Right side, it's Manhurts, the tight end. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. They'll run with Davis Price. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up second down.
I have a feeling they'll stay committed to running the football, especially on the early downs. They just haven't had a whole lot of success just yet.
So they get pushed back to the 11, and here's second and goal. To throw, it's Lance. drops this underneath for Davis Price.
Touchdown, 49ers. Ty Davis Price, an 11-yard touchdown. And the 49ers are an extra point away from drawing level. Robbie Gould on for the extra point. It's up and good, and we're tied at 7 here in quarter number 2. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. This is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. They had the interception last drive, led to the tying touchdown. So 7-7 the score as they begin first and 10. Throwing to start the drive, but that went incomplete.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. Play action. Now it's Murray. He's going to let this one go deep. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
I'm looking at this one with my defensive eyeglasses on, because you remember the old days when a tight end saw a linebacker covering him and thought he had a mismatch? But the way they can run nowadays, not necessarily so. They gave it a shot downfield. That one incomplete.
From the gun, Murray. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Like what I see so far out of this defense, because they've been showing their best coverages on 3rd down. So far, only allowed 1 conversion on a handful of attempts. One area of their game plan that they've executed to perfection.
On 4th down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. Returning it is Moore. And that one, a 55-yard punt, 13 on the return. And the Niners will go on offense, 1st and 10. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive.
Well, the football changing hands here, and as this offense takes a field, Charles, they'd be fine with more of the same on this upcoming drive. Last time out, they found the end zone for 6.
And they're certainly hoping for more of the same, but the game plan, I doubt it'll just be a carbon copy of the last drive, because I think this offense is ready to break out some new wrinkles and try some new things that might be hidden in their playbook. They want to use that confidence to its advantage, while also keeping the defense from anticipating what's up next.
And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. 46 yards rushing for him now, and he's carried the ball just 5 times. So in Saints territory now, here's 1st and 10 at the 32-yard line. Throwing now is Lance. And he slings one that's incomplete.
That certainly appeared to be a play call where they were just trying to make 2nd down, 2nd and short. I think they thought the coverage was off a little bit more than it was. Nice job there pressing up on it and forcing the incompletion.
Here's 2nd and 10 now from about the 32. 2nd down, here's Davis Price. And he's able to work his way down inside the red zone to the 19-yard line. 13 yards there and a Niner first. A nice run right there. And we talk this time of year about certain teams, certain players who don't have a lot of postseason history to speak of. And here's a man right here in his rookie season in the NFL, and he's being asked to carry the load at running back for this offense.
And he has acquitted himself nicely here in his rookie year. And look, I think we both believe that the burden is a little lighter on backs and receivers than it is on quarterbacks in the playoffs. But that's not to say this is going to be easy. As fast as the NFL game is in the regular season, it's like warp speed when you turn pressure up in the postseason. So let's see how he handles things early.
And they're going to lose some on this play. Being knocked back to the 18. Third throwing is Lance on third down. That caught by Manhurts. And he's got this inside the 10 to the 9 before he's out of bounds. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Davis Price on first and 10. And he's going to battle his way down right around the 2-yard line. 1:58 left to play till we hit halftime. From the 2 now, second and goal. Lance with a tap forward on the jet sweep. And this is not going to do it as he stopped at the 2-yard line. A nice play design there with the touch pass. Looked good at the start, but bottom line, the defense was ready.
And they did a nice job scouting, didn't they? Not just scouting, but now executing once they saw the play for real after having worked on it all week in practice. They drilled on the play, then they drilled him.
They'll try and run for it with Davis Price. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Ty Davis Price with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Niners have moved out in front. Gold able to tack on the extra point. And that makes the score 14-7. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gold now to kick it away. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started. That 7-0 lead of theirs short-lived as they've now given up 2 straight touchdowns to fall behind by 7.
Yeah, but no cause for discouragement here. Yeah, they've fallen behind, but haven't they proven that they can go down and score? So what was the formula that got them down there the first time? Get back to something close to that, and maybe they can get this game tied up. They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath.
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. See what they have drawn up here, a little bit behind the line, 12 yards needed to gain a first down. He's going deep for Brown. Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted. Picked up by Andrew Thomas.
And I think this is a situation where a quarterback coach in the sidelines is going to talk to a signal caller and say, listen, it's third and long, and it's still early in the game. Let's not force things here. If we don't feel good about it, let's just check something down and pump the football.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. They start near midfield following the interception as they begin first and 10. Nick Burton charging hard from that linebacker spot, and he drops him for a loss of 11. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Well, they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. He's going to fire one deep over the middle, and that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
I know conventional wisdom says, hey, don't get it all back in one play, but sometimes you go ahead and try to. They tried to get it all back on that one, weren't able to do so.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And he's got the hook up to Moore. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. Line of scrimmage moves from one 37-yard line to the other as they come up first and 10. Shotgun now for Lance. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by the corner, Bradley Roby. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. And We'll see if that pick six looms large as this game continues, because we've seen plays like that alter a lot of playoff contests over the years.
I would agree with that totally, and you often think to yourself, why do they alter it so much? Because after games, don't we hear coaches and players say, well, one play doesn't usually determine the outcome? But I don't think that's really true, do you? Because there's times when we see plays like that, and all of a sudden the momentum jumps to that team side, it deflates the other side, and they never pick it back up. And then things really go from there, don't they?
That's the thing for me. We talk about momentum changes. A play like that is the ultimate momentum change. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. Taken from about the 12. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And with only 9 seconds remaining, well, not much time, we'll see how they play this. And a big loss here as he's taken down. So we come upon halftime here in this NFC wild card matchup. As we'll send you back over to Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report, here's Jonathan Coachman. Welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gaudin, getting set for quarter number three here. One of these two teams about to play their final half of the season as we're back at it in this NFC wildcard bout. Taken from about the 12. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And CD, we are in for a very intriguing second half. This is what we wanted all time. This is what postseason football is all about.
It certainly is. And doesn't it speak to the parity in the NFL? Roughly half the teams that made the playoffs a year before miss the next year, get replaced. We know it's an any given Sunday mentality. Nothing's easy in the playoffs, but when you have your shot, they're eager to seize it.
To throw once more on second and 10. Lance. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. So first and 10 now from the 30. An option give to Davis Price. They find some open field here. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. 102 yards rushing for him now as he's run it 11 times. Boy, the offensive line there, that was a thing of beauty to watch them block.
I love how you give a little appreciation for those big guys up front, and well-deserved. But how about the execution behind them? You can see the hours of practice that have gone into it. Great pocket by the running back. Quarterback puts it right in the perfect spot. Great mesh point by them. The timing on point. The run even better.
Well, what looked like a march to the end zone has hit a momentary roadblock with that incompletion. No need to panic. They just got to come up with a high percentage play call and see if they can get their offense back on track.
Meanwhile, Lance's throw complete there to Moore. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route, and what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing, and they got it done.
Now he's going to be very close to a first down. Good running, but looks like he's a yard short. It's a gain of 5, and now the question, will the offense stay out there on 4th and 1?
Three, three.
try and run for it. And he gets the first down here as he's taken down at the 24.
He's been tough for this defense to handle, over 100 yards. You kind of knew that they were going to him on that play, didn't you?
They certainly did. That's one of those situations where you simply say, my best runner over my best blockers, let's go ahead and pick it up. And I don't care if they know it on the other side. Here we come, and they got it done.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
So it looks like they still have some fight in them on this series because it seemed like things were headed for the red zone. But if this defense gets two more stops, they can keep them out of that area.
Third quarter, wild card round. Thanks for being along for the playoff ride with us. Here's second and 10. Now play fake. Lance. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
That's a big force incompletion there to bring up third and long, and this defense can still salvage a little momentum by forcing them to kick a field goal, because just a few plays ago, they looked like they were headed towards the end zone.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Here's Lance. That's caught by Debo Samuel. Touchdown, San Francisco. A 24-yard touchdown. And the 49ers have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score on the opening drive of the second half. Gold with the extra point, and the lead is now 21-14. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gold now to kick it away. Taken at the 15, a short kick. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape, up past the 30. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. Well, Charles, you and I said at intermission, feels like we're set up for a good second half. Well, the other side scored, and now it's up to them to answer. How do they respond here with their first drive of the second half?
Well, bottom line is they just saw the ball go in the end zone against their defense, and they saw what good offense looks like. They believe they've got a good offense as well. Run the best plays you've got to the top performers you have and try to move that ball down the field for an answering score.
And he'll go down right around the 47 this time.
44 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Now a first down carry for Harris. Uses the stiff arm. And a good run here as he'll rumble all the way down to the 40-yard line. So from inside Niner territory now, this is first and 10, right at the 40. Murray now running right on the option. And he'll take this beyond the line of scrimmage as he slides to a halt. Give him 3 on the keeper there, and it is second down.
Anytime you decide to use your quarterback as a runner, most of the time when you design a play, you're expected to break a little bit bigger than this one, because when you run him on short gains, your risk reward and him taking hits, I'm not sure that's the payoff they were looking for.
They fake the handoff. Now Murray. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Murray with a third and long. Got a man. It's Brown. And they're going to get this to about the 44-yard line.
That pattern and scheme was well defensed on third down. He tried to just sprint from one side of the field to the other, and they got it to him quickly. But no chance at yards after the catch there, and they stop him short.
Company going for it on fourth. And that is intercepted. Or was it? Wait, they'll say no. No interception. He did not keep the feet in bounds, apparently. So that's just going to be an incompletion. So the defense has to stay out and get one more stop. They were able to do it, forcing the incompletion.
So on their record, that goes down as a successful play. It doesn't matter how they got there, how it happened. They got it done. They're the ones that are jubilant.
No gain on the play. It'll be second down. One quarter remains in this NFC wild card matchup. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Here's Lance to throw it. Gets it out wide to Davis Price. And he'll be brought down inside the 40-yard line.
Downfield, everyone trying to account for someone, but unfortunately they didn't account for the running back slipping out of the backfield, and he was absolutely unnoticed and wound up getting big yards on that play.
Read option, here's Davis Price, and they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. That good for 22 and a first down. They went with a nickel look defensively, so they had five defensive backs in there. Didn't help them stop the run.
Yeah, I love that. The nickel look, 5 cents, five DBs. But what also happens then? You take a big body off the field in order to insert that guy. So you're taking a big off for a little. And oftentimes you can run the football effectively against that defense.
Well, a clear running situation, trying to take time off the clock. You ran the previous play, set that play action up nicely.
Boy, did they ever, because they had shown the ability to run the football. So now you lose your keys as a defense. You dive for the running play, and they hit them over the top.
They give it five that time as they draw a bit closer here for a second and goal. Davis Price again. They hold him again, and now all of a sudden, it's third and goal at the one. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is a time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the...
That's caught by Debo Samuel. Touchdown, San Francisco. A great effort there. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the 49ers have opened up a two-touchdown lead here in this fourth quarter. Gold able to tack on the extra point. And the lead now up to 14. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gold now to kick it away. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. If they want to advance in this divisional round, look, obviously the time is now. Trailing here in the fourth as they go to work on a crucial, crucial drive, first and 10. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. Harris running straight ahead. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Byron Murphy there on the tackle. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Murray going to throw. Throwing out right here, caught by Olave. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. His second catch of this wild card game, and it goes for a first down.
Very nicely done there on the reception, and what an impact this rookie made on this offense, Charles, in the regular season.
Yeah, he's a big part of why they are where they are. He stepped into an important role, embraced it, and in a lot of ways expanded it, and immediately made a connection with his quarterback.
Oh, they've intercepted Murray for the third time. Buda Baker with a pick. Well, time, I mean, certainly not on their side offensively. They had to take some chances, but that interception will further hinder their already slim chance at victory.
Yeah, and you're talking about time not on their side, but it certainly is on the defense's side, and they understood that. They knew they had to press it a little bit, and they planned accordingly. And what a benefit for them, able to pick that one off and hopefully put this game away.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And intercepted, maybe the turning point they need. Picked off by Paulson Adebo. And the Saints are going to take possession of the football. Now with that interception, you feel like we got a ball game again. Remember, two-score contest and still time left here in the fourth.
And in the old days, not too long gone either. Throwing the ball here would have been an absolute no-no, but the way the game's played now.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Jordan Poyer. And the 49ers are going to take over at their own 30-yard line. If they had designs of kind of wiggling their way back into this one, that hurts their chances right there.
Yeah, to put it mildly, look at the lead, look at the deficit, trying to make a play downfield. Everyone seeking to be somewhat the hero. Didn't turn out that way at all, and you're exactly right. It's going to take a lot for them to have a chance to win this one now.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup. Davis Price up the middle. And he'll be pretty well stopped in his tracks. Give him a yard up to the 42.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on his faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. This is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here. On third down, here's Davis Price. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. And whistles, and we're going to have another stoppage of play as they call the timeout on defense with 1:53 left. Here comes the 49ers punter now as he'll punt it away for the second time. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Saints will take over with a first and 10 deep in their own territory. The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, when we were having a tough patch, this too shall pass, this too shall pass, and finally kept having a rough patch. He said, but you got to do something to make it pass, and that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. He'll get 15 and a Saints first down. And they'll bring the big tight end across the formation left. Throwing on first down is Murray. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. And the Niners are going to take possession of the football. That is now 5 interceptions that he has thrown in this ball game. If I asked you to speculate what's possibly going on in his head, what would you say?
Well, if he's as mentally strong as I believe he is, he understands that not all these picks have been his fault. You know, some of the throws, yes, but there have been a good number of them where he hasn't been helped by his own receivers, and they've turned into interceptions. So he knows if he keeps firing, perhaps good things can happen, not just in this game, but especially in later ones.
Line of scrimmage, again the 37 as they line up second and 10. Now it looks like he'll throw here. And he will find his man Samuel. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Touchdown! Deebo Samuel saving his best for the playoffs with his third touchdown of the game. And the 49ers continue to show why it pays to play at home in the postseason as they add on to their lead. Gold with the extra point, and the lead now to three touchdowns at 21. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gold now to kick it away. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things. He's got a man complete. Touchdown, Saints.
You got to understand situational football because they're playing with the lead here late in the ball game. So the back defender has got to be as deep as the deepest receiver. Keep everything in front of you, rally up and make the play.
Yeah, you would think they had the three-score lead. Now it's down to two, but three-score lead here late. But they wouldn't give up a big pass play like that, but they did. Lutz to try to add the PAT. And the lead will be cut down to 14. So two scores down, time definitely not an ally, but here comes the onside kick. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. So two scores down, time definitely not an ally, but here comes the onside kick. And the 49er hands team does its job. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. Give to Davis Price up the middle here. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two, as they get it with under a minute to go now in the football game. Now Lance. That complete over the middle. He's got Manhurts, the tight end. An option give to Davis Price. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. The last run got nine. That leaves him with second and a yard. This will be caught. It's Samuel. And the Niners are going to have a first and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line.
But when you're up by two scores in the fourth quarter and you're going to throw the football, expect to see a lot of man coverage, because usually what comes along with man coverage is pressure. So if you're a play caller and you want to keep throwing the football, that's fine. Just make sure your offensive line understands.
And across the goal line, into the end zone, touchdown 49ers. Ty Davis Price saving his best for the playoffs with his third touchdown. The 49ers have pretty well put it away here in the fourth quarter. Gold able to tack on the extra point, and the lead now to three touchdowns at 21. after the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. This is going to be returned from Newton. Now Brown, oh, he lost the football. And now this is scooped up by the 49ers. And they are going to take over right there at the 22-yard line.
So problems compounding themselves here on the return. They just give up the touchdown, and now they lose the football.
Yeah, partner, things are starting to unravel a little bit for them right in front of our eyes. They're going to be looking for some answers and quickly.
First play of the drive there is incomplete.
Well, fourth quarter with a 3-score lead here, Charles, but they're still going back to the air and looking for more points.
Well, with this game well in hand, it's an opportunity for the guys to come off the bench and get a chance to play. And a lot of coaches, they want to run their full playbook no matter who's on the field.
Now Lance throws the interception, his third. Picked off by the corner, Bradley Roby. And the Saints come up with a late turnover, but it will probably only matter to the statisticians as this ball game is now officially over. Getting into the playoffs is one thing. Now they get to move on. Just 8 teams left.
The dream stays alive. Everyone's gunning for the Super Bowl. That's the ultimate. But you have to get there in incremental steps. One win today gets them one step closer.
So many memories that I made on Casket Road. I done gained the world, I ain't never sell my soul. This is God-given, so I thank him as I go. Hate to sound conceited, but I know, I know, I know. Crazy thing they f*** with me. Yeah, crazy thing they f*** with me. Run up on me, baby, show you gon' see. Yeah, God power from my head and my feet. What I say is gospel. I cook this with love. They gon' eat it up and swallow me. I'm from the ghetto, babe. Seen bodies in the streets so I could tweet. I came from nothing. I turned a mustard seed into a million in the discussion. Had a TED talk with the higher me. Show me how to run it up. I need all my cheese. Every day that I wake up, I'm pinching myself. Can't believe that I'm really me. Popping shows in New Zealand. Boy, you is not eating, man. We do not play in the same league. I gave my mama some racks and she asked me if I'm selling tricks. I said, mama, please. If I was, do you think I'd let you know? Got so many memories that I made on Cascade Road. This is God-given, so I thank her as I go. This gon' sound conceited, but I know, I know, I know. Crazy thing they f*** with me. Yeah, crazy thing they f*** with me. Yeah, got power from my head to my feet. Yeah, run up on me, baby, so you gon' see.
Chase, I just attract what you put in, you get back. I'm screaming Campbell, Campbell, still hit the dance in the wherever I'm at. Feel like a champion, mama mentality. I am the masterpiece, life is the crap. Deep love me and I can't resist it, but I'm only guilty of slipping too fast. Life is by legacy, what lies ahead of me, helping to get peace with this past. Little bitty regular that I pack, 007 before you react.
Don't think twice, my only advice for my granddad before he passed. Look to the stars, look at the sky at night. Tell me that heaven ain't black on everything I love. Try not to brag till you bring it up. Turn the vision, block opinions, and I could give a but think of us. Duck, jab, hook, send it through the roof with an uppercut. Tell the truth, shut the devil up. In the booth, I'm a touch of a crazy thing they f*** with me.
Yeah, crazy thing they f*** with me. Run up on me, baby, so you gon' see. Yeah, got power from my head and my feet.
check it. Okay, I feel unstoppable. Losing's impossible. Go against the team, the thing they know not to do. Bright lights, game on the line. Do what I gotta do. Time after time, we do the impossible. You ain't made it till you got stylists go out and shop for you. You ain't made it till they pour on top of you. Parading through the city, the whole block come out for you. We just getting started, y'all finna see what we bout to do. Boy, stop, you ain't here, I'm the real truth. Hunters real blues, trips on them still new. Shopping at Dover Street, I'm dripping like mildew. They say you don't visit the hood, dog, I still do. A real one, only difference, my bill's bigger. I'm still with ya, I just got rich a little quicker. The same man, God handed me his game plan. I ain't perfect, far from it, what can I say, man? I feel unstoppable, losing's impossible. Go against the team, the thing they know not to do. Bright lights, game on the line, do what I gotta do. Time after time, we do the impossible.
It felt like yesterday, I was just driving my grandma's Chevrolet. From South Carolina to Maryland, I take the jet today. I'm still on the come up, I'm still building my resume. I still got a lot to prove, but still I'm heavyweight. I still gotta watch my moves. They tried to defamate my character, but I won't let them. It's always checkmate. I'm still screaming, the world hope she. Mother Nature's my first shorty. Watch how I go ballistic, and I'm so terrific. Accounts is copacetic. I don't need no permission, but I'm so indebted to this game that I love, and most of all to the man above. Now check me out. Now I was just that Fridays was serving the greens. Before I was popping, I was nursing my dreams. Now I ain't never been a gangster, but I know a few things. I just rather get the bag and start collecting the rings. Now I done spoke too much, close curtain is seen. I am not a human being, I'm a fool machine. I ain't holier than thou, I don't judge, I seen. Just staying down for the come up till I reign supreme. Let's get it. Yeah, hit boy, you got another one. Man, y'all boys ain't ready for this, man. I'm still grinding, I'm still hungry, hungrier than ever. I feel unstoppable, losing's impossible. Go against the team, the thing they know not to do. Bright lights, game on the line, do what I gotta do. Time after time, we do the impossible.
In the dark, and I keep getting stronger. My limit's the sky. I do the impossible, impossible.
Shine if I want to. I win every time if I want to. The world mine if I want to. Make the world mine cause I want to.
I pull the sword out the border, walk a floor full of cobras. Go to war with you all, we can brawl toe to toe. I can tighten loops in my lace and make lightning lose in a race. I make fire cool and come back from the triangle in Bermuda. I can suit up, live in the moon up, working and outsmarting computers. I can outswim all the tuna, and that's without a scuba. So in the laws of nature, I'm breaking the rules. Only thing I'm bad at is being a loser. I can make time traveling a surprise. Make graveyards feel alive. Break the immortal down to his demise. Look up and beam to the stars so you can turn off the lights.
I come alive in the dark. And I keep getting stronger. Tonight I hunt with the pride. You can't take my pride away. I can sing with the birds and the trees in the morning. Or roll like the storms way over the ocean. My limit's the sky. I do the impossible, impossible.
Shine if I want to. I win every time if I want to. The world mine if I want to. Make the world mine cause I want to.
Even on the days when I'm late as ever, my timing is right. Even in the darkest moments, stay close, I'm that shining the light. I can make an earthquake nervous. I can make the sun wear a visor. I can make a wise owl see me as a daily advisor. I'm that cool shade, peaceful night that's